We have a patient with multiple antibodies. 2 units of red cells have been ordered for transfusion, and we need to identify the antibodies, cross-match units that lack the corresponding antigens, and discuss strategies to minimize the potential of patient making additional antibodies.
Did you hear? Marina got that job as the technical specialist in the Immunohematology Reference Lab at the National Institutes of Health Clinical Center Blood Bank.
I did not know that. What is the National Institutes of Health?
The National Institutes of Health is the primary federal agency for conducting and supporting medical research, helping to lead the way toward important medical discoveries that improve people's health and save lives worldwide. The NIH campus is located in Bethesda, Maryland, and has a world-class hospital, the NIH Clinical Center. Similar to many hospitals, there are teams of people employed whose mission it is to provide care, services, and products for our patients. Our team includes allied healthcare professionals, such as clinical laboratory scientists.
The Department of Transfusion Medicine and the Center for Cellular Engineering are located on several floors within the NIH Clinical Center. DTMCCE provide clinical services to support NIH patients in need of blood component therapy, cellular therapy, therapeutic apheresis, and specialized laboratory diagnostics. In addition to our AABB, FDA, and ASHI accreditations, we maintain special accreditations for our Immunohematology Reference Laboratory and 2 educational training programs, the Transfusion Medicine Blood Bank Fellowship and the Specialist in Blood Bank Technology Program. There are over 200 employees in the DTMCCE. Our most famous to date is Dr. Harvey J. Alter. Dr. Alter is the co-winner of the 2020 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for the discovery of the hepatitis C virus. He is an active faculty member of the educational programs in the DTMCCE.
Wow, that's really neat. A Nobel Prize winner. What a great place to work.
Sure is. Now what about that technical specialist position? I wonder what experience or credentials Marina needed to get that position.
Many technical specialists hold a Specialist in Blood Bank certification. These SBBs are knowledgeable about all things related to blood and biotherapies. There are several pathways one can follow to become a specialist in blood bank technology. Going through an accredited face-to-face program like ours is one route.
The SBB program at the NIH is a 1-year certificate program that is delivered face-to-face with a maximum of 3 students. The students have a dual role as part-time employee and student. Classes are held 1 day per week. Clinical rotations are scheduled throughout the year, and an independent research project must be completed within the year.
The part about working and being a student, that sounds like a great opportunity. I wonder what kind of blood bank the DTM has.
The Transfusion Service Laboratory, where students are part-time employees, is a full-service blood bank. Blood products are collected on campus and locally for transfusions to our patients. In laboratory, we prepare components such as fresh frozen plasma, red cells collected from whole blood, and we also collect them from apheresis. We also pathogen-reduced platelets collected by apheresis and label blood products, then transfer them to our local transfusion services where they are selected and prepared for use to our patients. Technologists participate in platelet inventory management and component modifications, including washing, irradiating, thawing, pooling, freezing, and deglacing of our units. We also have AABB accredited Immunohematology Reference Laboratory, which resolves complex serological problems using a vast array of tools, including molecular platforms.
Oh, that's cool. That's really a full-service blood bank. I wonder if the program has any current students.
Hi, I'm Ashley, and I'm a current SBB student at the NIH.
Hi, I am Robel, and I am a current SBB student at the NIH.
You will gain a wealth of knowledge about the world of blood banking.
Between working and attending classes, the SBB program requires dedication, hard work, and above all else, proper time management to be successful.
In addition, we are both involved in research at the NIH. For my research project, I'm working with the Center for Cellular Engineering to simplify the current method of depleting red cells by comparing the manipulation of bone marrow manually versus automated.
My project is testing the effects of irradiation on pathogen-reduced platelets compared to platelets that have not been irradiated.
You know, Ashley and Robel seem like they're having a really good time.
Yes, what a great learning experience. I wonder if the NIH graduates pass the national examination.
Yeah, I'm curious about the research projects and where the graduates are working.
The overall ASCP examination pass rate since 1994 for our graduates is 96%. Many of our graduates hold positions in hospitals, blood centers, and reference laboratories. Other positions include regulatory, quality assurance,
cellular engineering, industry, and education. Research projects done during the program year can be submitted for scholarships, and we have been very successful to receive the AABB Future Leaders Scholarship, about one in every two submissions. There may be several opportunities to publish while in our program. SBB student projects leading to publication is about 50%, with approximately 80% of the graduates being the first author.
I'm going to apply.
Me too.
Oh, great. Looks like we may have new students.
This is exciting. Let's go and get ready for a new class.